Hello again. The CEO of Kibo Mining, Louis Coetzee, is with me here at the Proactive Studio. Great to have you here, Louis. You haven't been in for a while. Bring us up to date on what Kibo's been up to.
Yes, indeed. I was just listening when you were stating the question. I had a similar question from a shareholder who just recently said to me that he thinks we could do a little bit more. And I said to him, do you have a bit of time we can discuss this? And I was about halfway through of what we've been doing. He said, I think I more or less get the picture now.
So very busy then.
So we've been very busy indeed. We've also been working on a number of things over the last couple of months, mostly on repositioning Kibo as an energy company, moving it out, standalone pure energy company, and it will become an energy company with a diversified energy portfolio, become a regional player in the region where we work. Apart from that, as a first step towards achieving that, we've just announced the transaction in Botswana, where we're in the process of acquiring the Mabasekwa project, which is very similar to our Mbeya Coal to Power project, MCPP as we normally refer to it, and it's almost identical, the two projects, and that's the first stepping stone. Apart from all the other things that we've been doing over the last year and longer to develop that further.
Let's talk about that transformation then. So originally a resources company and moving on now to completely transforming that idea into an integrated energy portfolio. Yes. Give us some more detail on that.
Well, it's actually not news. We've been doing this for the last 3 years already, or actually longer. In 2012, when we readmitted Kibo as a part of a reverse takeover, we had a huge portfolio of exploration assets. We decided to develop all of those, see which of those can go the distance, which can go and stand on their own. We've done all of that. The most recent one was when we reversed our gold assets into Katoro, a reverse takeover, which was readmitted in May. And we were left with the Mbeya Coal to Power project, our flagship project. And we now have to put that on its way as well. So it's actually an evolving strategy that we've been following for the last 4 years already.
So you're leaner and meaner. Let's concentrate on Mbeya in Tanzania if we can. Is that now over the line? There was a PPA that you were having to cross the T's and dot the I's on. Tell us about the detail on that.
Well, we haven't signed the PPA yet. It's a process that's ongoing at the moment. We are waiting to sign the Memorandum of Understanding, which is a prerequisite. We have to do that. That's part of the Tanzanian process. You cannot do the PPA before you haven't signed the MOU. That's taken us much longer than what we would like it to take. That's mostly, as we've been saying in all our announcements throughout the year, as a result of dramatic changes in Tanzania, in TANESCO, the power utility. Their management changed. There were certain policy changes in the government. But I would hasten to add that in the last 4 months, we've seen a dramatic change again, where all these management changes, all the policy changes are now coming into effect. And we're very confident that this process will conclude very quickly.
You say confident. Have you got any kind of time frame for investors watching? What sort of time frame are you looking at?
So we're confident, as I said, that it will close within the next month. We hope that it will be much sooner than that. Our most recent interaction with the government gives us all the indications and sort of assures us that it will happen very quickly now.
Keep us up to date when it does. But presumably when that PPA is agreed by the Tanzanian government, you will then be all guns blazing on the Mbeya project.
Well, I think the important thing is, up to now, because the MCPP is our flagship project, that's where all the focus is, that's where everybody is paying attention, everybody's waiting for this MOU to be signed and to get completed. I understand that, but we have to understand what we announced last week changes the company. We now have another project as well in Botswana. We are repositioning this company as a pure energy play. It creates tremendous new investment opportunity. It creates tremendous new value potential that we can unlock. That does not take our focus away from the MCPP. MCPPs are still our flagship project, still the one that we will be driving. It's still the one that provides the foundation and the momentum for everything that we're doing now at the moment.
But using that foundation and using that momentum, would it be fair to describe Kibo as having a kind of cookie cutter approach to projects in Africa like the one in Botswana and moving with your experience to different locations with exactly the same plan?
Well, we've gained a lot of experience and knowledge and understanding in the development of the MCPP. I think that's best reflected in the recognition that we've received from companies like General Electric, our equipment supplier for that project, and SEPCO3, our EPC contractor, and a number of other major players in the world that has recognized our approach in this, our success in developing it, and we're going to leverage off that. Definitely, we're going to leverage off that. I think it provides us with tremendous opportunity to actually go and unlock value in other similar projects, which has been stagnating quite a bit, and that can benefit from this approach.
And presumably when you bump into that shareholder once again who accuses you perhaps of not being busy enough, you'll be able to give a similar answer at the same time next year?
Well, I totally understand his frustration. I share that frustration in the sense that things, we would all like to see things move much quicker. I think the important thing to understand is that fundamentally nothing has changed. The value in the project and projects that we're now developing is increasing. The transaction of last week actually brings tremendous, a huge lot of additional value, and we'll keep on developing and unlocking that.
Come back and tell us all about it soon.
Definitely will.
Thanks very much indeed.
Thank you.
Thank you.